What is going on, guys? Welcome to Greg Olson's TV Daily, your source for daily tech news. Make sure you subscribe so you know what's going on in the world of tech. How is everyone doing? Hope you're having a fantastic day. We've got a couple of stories for you. Both are about the Galaxy S24 Ultra. So let's go. Our first story of the day is, will the S24 Ultra have that much faster charger and bigger battery? There's been rumors going back and forth. Well, this phone has gone through some certification in China, and we get the answers because of that certification through China. And here's the information. It's saying that don't believe the rumors that the S24 Ultra will adopt 65 watts and 5,500 milliamps. I can confirm that they are false. So you're still going to be looking at 45 watt charging and a 5,000 milliamp battery, which HN2 had really, really good battery life, so wouldn't worry about it that much. And the HN3 will probably have just as good, if not better, battery life and definitely better performance. So overall, it's not really a big loss, but it is something that, you know, if you wanted to have charged that phone, especially a lot faster than you could have, it's not happening again for the millionth time in a row. But maybe next year, guys, maybe the year after that, we'll wait and see. Our last story of the day has to do with the processor inside of the Galaxy S24 Ultra, 24 and 24 Plus. We've been hearing rumors that it might have the Snapdragon HN3 across the world. We've heard that it will only be, you know, very small amounts of countries that have the HN3 and the rest will get the Exynos 2400. What is the final answer? Well, it looks like the final answer, or more confirmation, however you want to think about it and put it, is that the S24 Ultra definitely uses the Snapdragon regardless of the region. Again, that's for the 24 Ultra only, and the 24 and 24 Plus still have an 8 gig RAM option. While it's not certain whether the 8 gig RAM is only used with 128 gig storage, the 12 gig RAM option definitely exists. So it sounds like the Exynos 2400 will only come to some of the countries that get it anyway, but only for the phones of the 24 and the 24 Plus. If you get the 24 Ultra, regardless of where you live, it will be the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3. So I know a lot of you end up buying the better version of that phone, which is the Ultra, the best version. So you should be okay at that point. Question of the day is, do you think the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 and the Exynos 2400 processor drama is kind of overblown, or you don't care? Let me know how you feel about those processors in the comments down below. Have a great day, and we'll see you down the road.